Hello, welcome back to my channel. You are welcome back to my channel. Thank you for stopping by. If today is your first day of seeing me, you are welcome. If you have been with me all this while, you are welcome. Thank you for stopping by. Now, if you have been with me all this while, God bless you. Today is your first time of seeing my face. God bless you. I'm so happy to see you. Please subscribe to this channel. With God, all things are possible. It's all about solutions, simple solution to the challenges of life. And whenever you subscribe, just on the notification bell to be the first to be notified whenever I upload another video. And please share the video. Just give me a like. You don't know we are going to help. Share the video and the Lord will bless you. My name is Mercy Ogun. In today's video, I will be talking to us, explaining to us the needs, the principle that we need to put together in order to be powerful. It's all about how to be powerful. As a human being in life, you have to be powerful. Yes. As a child of God, you have to be powerful. You have to know the rules and regulations. Because John 10:10 said, the devil has come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. He said in the book of Mark chapter 10, verse 19, behold, he has given you the power to trample upon scorpions and serpents. If you drink any deadly poison, it will not help you. But yet you find out that the power is not working for you the way it's supposed to work. Whenever you say something is not really happening. Yes. But after this video, after watching this video, you'll be able to know one or two things you need to understand in order for the power to work for you. Number one in my list here is to know the truth. Know the truth and the truth shall set you free. Know the truth and the truth shall set you free. God knows you by your name. He marks you by your name. Why the devil marks you by your sin? If you know the truth, the tricks of the devil, you know the truth, you can be able to avoid the tricks of the devil. Yes, devil is really trickish and he knows how to manipulate people, knows the lies of the devil, and you'll be able to overcome them. Number two, you must be able to forgive one another, love one another. God has commanded us to love yourself, love your neighbor as yourself, be a give, a helping hand. Forgive one another. Forgive yourself. Your past mistake, your past ignorance, forgive yourself. Don't be reminding yourself of the past. Forgive yourself and forgive one another. If you are praying, you have grudges against others in your mind. Your prayer, can you channel your prayer to God? Your prayer will not go anywhere. But if you forgive one another, whenever you communicate with God, God will always hear you. Be an obedient servant. Obey God. Obey the rules of the land. Obey the rules of the organization. The organization, the company, the employee that they are paying you salaries and wages. Obey the rules and regulations guiding that organization. Don't be a disobedient staff. Don't be a disobedient child of God because it will not pay you. Obey before complain. Always obey. If you obey others, they will obey you. If you obey God, whenever you command things to come, those things we obey you are come. Whatever you ask to go, we also obey you. Yes. If you disobey, other things will not listen to you. As a human being, control your tongue. Talk less. When you talk too much, you lose your value. Be unpredictable. Let them not be able to predict you. But some people, they've predicted, as you come now, you will talk. Once you are there, who is talking is you. Talk less. Sometimes you talk out your secret to your enemy. Don't always talk because the life and death is in the power of the tongue. You are expecting something, let those things come. Keep it to yourself. When they come, share the testimony. Because it's not everybody that wants your joy. Don't always tell them. Tell them everything you are telling them. You are telling them, no. Control your tongue. Control the way you talk. Even the way you talk to people. Because you don't know who you are going to shout at, and then you put yourself into trouble. Eat, watch what you eat. Don't eat too much. Don't just be eating anywhere you see yourself you eat. You want to be powerful, you must have a power backing you up. You cannot just be powerful without no power backing you up. That is why Jesus is there. The own power that is backing me up, that is giving me the boldness, the confidence that I'm carrying about is liquid fire. You want to know the liquid fire? That is the Holy Spirit. That's the liquid fire. That's my backup. You want him to back you up, you just give your life to Jesus. And that is it. You live a life of holiness and righteousness, he will be there. He will just, the liquid fire will flow from your head to toe. Anytime they shoot you arrow, it will bounce back. You just be like a stone. When they pour water, the water will flow back. Anything wants to enter, the fire will melt them. That is one that is backing me up. There is nobody that is powerful that doesn't have anything backing them up. If God did not back you up, Satan will back you up. But it's better for God to back you up, because then you always see gain. Then you always have joy. You want to be powerful, know God for yourself. Be able to understand the language of the spirits. Know God for whom God is. Don't be somebody that will push you here and there. They push you here and there. No. Don't be somebody that when they shake you vigorously, you just fall off. Be somebody that when they shake you, you will stand. When they shake you vigorously again, you become astounding. Know God for yourself. Be able to differentiate the voice of God and the voice of flesh and the voice of men. Don't be carried away by lies of the devil, by deceit, by vain doctrines. By vain doctrines, know God for yourself. Understand the language of the spirit. In the realm of the spirit, there are rules and regulations. The spirit controls the physical. But the Bible tells us, Matthew 8:18, anything you change on earth can be, it will be changed in heaven. Anything you ban on earth shall be banned in heaven. So when you understand the language of the spirit, you will be able to walk aligned with it. Things will fall into places for you. In the realm of the spirit, there are rules and regulations. There are lines that you must follow. There are lines you must not cross. It's just like light and darkness. Darkness can never comprehend light. You are for light, you shine. You are for darkness, you belong to the dark. Understand the language of the spirit. Don't let them confuse you. Don't let them deceive you. When you understand the language, you know how to walk with them. He said he's make his angels spirits and make his ministers a flame of fire. Know your angels. Know how to align with your angels. Know how to call your angels, activate them. Know how to activate your angels. It's very, very important you activate them. Most of you, the angel that is following you is delay, is sorrow, is set by disappointment. Remove them, replace. Yes, whenever good things are about to come, anger will set in, in order for them to rob you of those things. Know how to align yourself with your angels, with your chi, with your guardian angel. If you are the type that is always suffering, you are the type you hardly see joy, tell God to change those angels for you. There's this sister that she complained that in her place of work, they always use her, she work like anything, but when they want to favor, they don't look at her face. When they want to bless, they don't look at her. It's just like a broom. When they need you, they will use you to sweep and clean. When they are done with you, they will keep you. When they need you again, they will come for you. When they are done with you, it's not supposed to be so. You are giving out favor. You should also receive favor. Yes. All you just need, just carry out a fasting, 6 to 12. Pray with fruit. I posted a video how you can pray with fruit. Pray with fruit. Ask God for mercy. And go and share this fruit. This time around, you are not eating. Share it among beggars. Share fruit with the little change you have. Share with your Adam. And when you come and say, God, I have activated my angels now. Let my angels begin to work for me. Let them align with all my ways, all my expectation. I remove the angel of sorrow, I replace with joy. I remove the angel of sadness, I replace with peace. I remove the angel of setback, I remove the angel of disfavor, I replace with favor. You just change them. Do you know why it's very important for you to replace? Because the devil is a roaring lion. He is roaming about. Later, we come back again. That anger that you have removed, if you have not replaced it with the spirit of calmness, when he will now come back again, see that the house is vacant, he will just enter. He will not just enter alone. He will just go and bring other servants according to the scripture and will occupy them. So anyone you remove, you will replace it. I was once a victim until the desperation came that you can change your angels. And ever since I did that, I have seen changes. Line is always falling onto me in pleasant places. Whenever I need help, I get. Even when I come, people that I don't know will go extra mile to help me. Also, be a problem solver. Don't always create problems for people. Try to solve the little one you can solve. You want to be powerful? Try to solve the little problem you can solve. As you solve other people's problems, people always be ready to solve your problem at any point in time that you need them. Know that angels, God has made you a fire. He makes the ministers a fire and a flame of fire. And the angels, spirits, angels are spirits. They listen to you. When you wish death, the one for death will answer. When you wish life, the one for life will come. Yes, it's like that. Know how to activate them. Another thing I want you to consider again, you want to be powerful. You understand the law of creation. It is very, very important. The Bible says, Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. It says, God said, be fruitful and multiply. Have dominion over everything. Be able to use what God has created to bring positive results, to bring blessing to your life. Understand the law of creation, the law of nature, the elements of life. Be able to know when to come out and bless yourself with the morning dew. Know when to use the rain to bless yourself. Know when to send the sun message. Know when to give a command to the sun. Know when to give a command to the moon and the star. Know when to send thunder message. It is very, very important. Know when to use the wind. Know when to use the water. It is very important. If you don't know, the enemy will be using those elements against you. They will be sending their message against you, and it will be going. But when you know when to speak. You know when to use them for your blessing. You know when to send them back, attack back to sender. For example, the Bible said, anywhere your soul enter, anywhere you put your feet, he has given unto you for a possession. You find yourself in a country that things is not working out. Just pick the sound of that country and speak. I'm a stranger in this place. I don't know what have happened in this place. I don't know what have happened in this country. But I came here for greener pastures. All I want for you is blessing. You must bless me. Yes, you must bless me. I have no reason to partake in the problem of the country. You must bless me. You pray very well and put that sand in your bathing water and use it to bathe. 3 days, you will see changes. The good of that land will be your portion, will become your friend, because every place has positive and negative. The good of that land will become your friend. You park into a house and they tell you that house, nobody stays in that house and move forward. Somebody else enter and begin to move forward, because the person understand the law of creation. You understand that I'm a visitor in this house. I paid my rent. You are to bless me. I didn't come here to come and fight you. Whatever that was done in this place is none of my business. I will stay here in peace and I'll pack out in peace. I did not come to fight you. So all I need from you is to serve me back. I paid my rent to stay here. Serve me back with blessing, with favor. And you will see those things begin to work in just the way you wish them to be. It's interesting, isn't it? There are many, but I think this one is very, very important that you know. For you to be powerful, you must know all these principles. You must know how to apply them. Align yourself with your angel. Be able to understand the power of creation and understand the way God wants you to do things. That holiness and righteousness is the key. Without it, no man will see God. Until I come your way again, I remain one and your only sister, Mercy. Please, if you find this teaching interesting, just share the video and you will save a soul. You don't need to run enter scatter looking for who will give you power. No, you just go to the Holy Spirit, which is the liquid fire. Let it be your backup and you will see things will begin to work for you. Yes, if you have any other ways, any other principle that can make somebody to be powerful, Please put it down at the coming session because we are here to share knowledge. Until I come your way again. Bye. God bless you. Subscribe. Subscribe.